Book is a book. It can be an ocean of mysteries too. If reviewed and shared rightly, it can have magical effects. Let us see what type of magic Trisha kept in store for us through her book review. Here we go.
Thanks for having me, Sourabhya. Good evening, everyone. This is Trisha, and you are listening to Global Beats GIIS Abu Dhabi radio station. I have been a book lover even before I started reading at the age of 3. My mother says that I would sit with a book or a newspaper as a 2-year-old and pretend to read it aloud to everyone at home. Luckily for everyone, I became a silent reader and books became my best friends. Now, I'm a big Enid Blyton fan, be it her poems, her short stories or her novels. I love them all. I'm an ardent fan of her Saintless series and I love the series quite dearly. Today, I shall review one of my favorite books in the series, The Twins at St. Clair's. Let me start with the characters first. The O'Sullivan twins, Pat and Isabel, are the first characters to look at. Twins in Enid Blyton books are naturally inseparable, and Pat and Isabel O'Sullivan are no exception. I must admit that I did not warm up to the twins at first. They live up to their nickname, the stuck-up twins, given to them when they arrive by the rest of their form. After their previous school ridge roofs, where the girls' father feels they have been given too many airs and graces, St. Clair's is a down-to-earth school. The twins start the book by telling their parents that they won't try to be good at St. Clair's because they would rather go to Ringmere School with their friends Mary and Frances White. To be fair, Ringmere does sound much better than St. Clair's. Great food, individual bedrooms, and evening dresses for dinner. So the twins decide to badger their parents and see if there's any chance they might go there. Alas, their parents have become concerned at how spoiled and brattish their daughters are becoming and say that a dose at a sensible school will sort them out. The twins maintain that they will go to the school if they must, but will jolly well do their worst there. So the twins arrive at St. Clair's, sulky and determined to fail. Soon after, the twins start getting into trouble. They don't muck in with the rest of the class and the older girls and get put in their place time and time again. Even the head girl, Winifred James, ticks them off for refusing to do their chores. The girls then start to muck in a bit after a word from Miss Theobald, the headmistress, and Winifred, and start to make some friends. They also begin to try hard to be somebody's in the school. However, the girls don't keep to the rules, disobeying another sixth former, Belinda Towers, by going into town when they have been told not to, just as Pat gets selected for the lacrosse team. In the end, she owns up to Belinda, and for her honesty, she's allowed to play in the match. That was touching. Other people in the twins' form include their head of dormitory, Hillary, who tries to keep the twins in line, June, who's the class comic, Doris, Sheila, and Kathleen, who becomes a particular friend to the twins throughout the term. And in the end, the three seem like firm friends, Pat even asking Kathleen for her address at the end of the term. The secret visit to the circus, the cinemas, the midnight feast, the dog smuggling are all beautiful little events that made the twins have a change of heart towards the school they so hated to be in. The teachers in the book are exceptionally interesting too. Miss Theobald is very involved in the girls' lives. The O'Sullivan twins' foremistress, Miss Roberts, is a nice, strong character. Poor Miss Kennedy, the history teacher, who is terrified of cats, comes in for a lot of wicked tricks from the girls. But how things change when the twins accidentally overhear a conversation is something to look forward to. One teacher the twins really don't like much, especially in the beginning, is their French mistress, Mamselle, who gets nicknamed Mamselle Abominable because abominable is Mamselle's favorite expression when something goes wrong. Platon does try to address a few issues, such as the fact that teachers too can be vulnerable and suffer at the hands of total students. Through the Sheila incident, she tries to underscore that money and servants and caste didn't matter at all. It was the person underneath that mattered. It's a neat little story about the O'Sullivan twins' first term at their new school, St. Clair's. The chapters are short and episodic, almost like they should have been published in Blyton's magazines. But despite its weaknesses, the twins at St. Clair's is a lot of fun and a good start to a fabulous series. That's it from me today. This is Trisha signing off. Over to you, Saurabhya.
Thank you, Trisha. I thoroughly enjoyed. Felt like we were traveling through that book. You made us to add one more name in the list of our favorite books. Facts. Facts can be fascinating.